8:35. News at 7 starts now.
So right now, we do want to turn your attention to an important and also a scary issue hundreds of thousands of people have to face every single day. Domestic violence. Whether it be committed by a mother, a father, a husband, or a wife, domestic violence happens everywhere, every single day. According to the National Coalition Against Domestic Violence, one in every four women will experience domestic violence in their lifetime. 85% of victims are women, and that's worse here. Most cases of domestic violence are never even reported. Joining us now live from New York is Judge Jeanine Pirro. And Judge Pirro, thanks so much for joining us. October is Domestic Violence Awareness Month, so why is this such a cause that you're feeling so strongly about?
You know, Heidi, I started one of the first domestic violence units in the nation as a young prosecutor in 1978, and I've tried so many of these cases, and I've fought for the rights of battered women, and I've watched this this problem, which is continues to be pervasive in our society, continue to today. And that's why I think today is so important in recognizing what the Empire Beauty School is doing. You know, they're literally putting their money where their mouth is, and they're making sure that anyone who comes on this Saturday, October 9th, to an Empire student salon in the Empire Beauty Schools, who gets a haircut, a color, a manicure, any service, 100% of the proceeds will be given to local domestic violence shelters. So this is an opportunity for stylists, and they have a special program, Heidi, and it's called Cut It Out, where the stylist can identify and maybe recognize someone who's suffering from domestic violence, and in this Cut It Out program, talk to them about what is out there in terms of help. They're non-judgmental, they're supportive, and they're connecting them with the National Domestic Violence Hotline. That telephone is 1-800-799-SAFE. And the Empire Beauty Schools, in doing this on Saturday, are recognizing that the problem continues to today and that there's a lot more that we still need to do.
This really is a good idea, but what can we do as maybe friends or family members of someone who's going through this? Because often we hear from victims that their attacker said they're sorry, they'll never do it again, and yet they do it again and again and again, and they keep staying with them because they think they really do love me, they really are sorry, but they're not.
Heidi, you hit the nail on the head. I mean, that's the question that people ask. Why do they stay? And the reason they stay is a myriad of reasons, because they've been so beaten down that they think they deserve what's happened. They think they're wrong. You know, the abuser has convinced them that he wouldn't do it if they would only do X, Y, or Z, when violence is not excusable in any way, shape, or form. So to answer your question directly, what can we do? We can recognize the signs. Stylists in the Empire Beauty School can do it because they work with the head and they see the hands and the neck when they're working with them. But we can try to recognize when people are being isolated from family and friends, when they're wearing turtlenecks at inappropriate, you know, seasons, when, you know, they're very, you know, they don't show up for things when they normally would. It's a problem that we all have to recognize. And make no mistake, one out of four women in this country is a victim of domestic violence during her lifetime. You and